Good evening, doctors. Myself, Dr. Hemant Sharma, and today I am going to explain you about the pre-renal failure. So, my dear friends, what is it? Its definition means azotemia caused by decreased perfusion to the kidney. There is decreased supply of blood to the kidney, decrease in pressure in afferent arterioles, the pressure decreases, and bowman space, hence the GFR also decreases. When GFR decreases, the blood supply decreases, pressure decreases, the RAS system activate, its renin, angiotensin, aldosterone system activate. Why it's activate? Because it thinks kidney in our body there is hypovolemia, but the supply of blood is decreased to the kidney only, not in whole body. So this is system activate, which increase the blood pressure. Aldosterone also increases here, which decreases. Aldosterone responsible for sodium and water reabsorption. Here the aldosterone decreases. Sorry, my dear friends, this decreases aldosterone because there is low supply of blood, and hyponatremia because it can't absorb sodium. So what happened? Urine sodium low because aldosterone decrease, fraction, ejection fraction sodium low, high or smallerity, blood urea and nitrogen and creatinine ratio high because it's failure due to lack of blood supply. What are the causes? Causes: renal artery stenosis, NSID, systemic hypoaldosterone, Addison disease and hepatorenal syndrome. Now we will take individually. Now I am going to explain renal artery stenosis. Sometime bilateral, what happens when there is narrowing of renal artery, secondary to the atherosclerosis, or maybe rare cases fibromuscular dysplasia. Sometime what happens, this artery blocks and not functioning properly, and not enough blood supply to the kidney. That's why pre-renal failure occurs. How to diagnose this? Diagnose with a renal artery arteriogram. It's the ideal definitive diagnosis, but we can see like creatinine, that is increases, and urine sodium low, hyponatremia, hyperkalemia. How to treat? First, our target to control LDL. Sorry, dyslipidemia we need to control by statins. Rosuvastatin, pavastatin, lovastatin, so many statins. Atorvastatin. But final, the treatment, if statin not responding, we need to go for angioplasty surgery. But never use AC inhibitor, guys. Here it's severely contraindicated. That's why I am written with red color. Is this contraindicated? No need to use here. Then NSID. NSID causes pre-renal failure. How it causes? Because pre-existing renal disease like diabetic nephropathy, patient already suffering from renal disease like diabetic nephropathy, bilateral RAS, it's renal artery stenosis, uncontrolled hypertension. If we give in such situation NSIDs, NSID work to block the synthesis of prostaglandin. And what is the work of prostaglandin, dear friends? Prostaglandin dilate the afferent arterioles and increase the pressure in afferent arterioles. But if we give NSID, it block prostaglandin, so there is constriction of the arterioles and pressure decreases, which causes pre-renal failure. How to treat this situation? Stop NSIDs. Stop NSID, my dear friend, need to stop. Systemic, like hypovolemia, hypovolemic shock, septic shock, infectious shock, cardiogenic shock. There also pre-renal failure. So what we need to do? See the ABC, airway, breathing, blood circulation, etc. We need to see the vitals, BP, pulse, everything. You have to monitor, see his saturation, and need to treat the cause. Okay, now hypoaldosteronism, Addison disease. What is it? It's an autoimmune disorder of adrenal, which results in decreased cortisol and decreased aldosterone. Hypoaldosteronism, what happened? That's why it can't be able to absorb sodium and water, because aldosterone works to absorb sodium and water. Have you ever heard about Waterhouse-Friderichsen syndrome? Very important. There is a hemorrhage to the adrenal gland due to infectious causes. It also causes hypoaldosteronism. How to diagnose? Diagnose by ACTH stimulation test, and we see the decreased level of cortisol there. So how to treat? If cortisol decreases, we need to replace with hydrocortisone, 100 mg or 200 mg doses. And if there is a decreased aldosterone, mineralocorticoid, we can say, we need to replace with fludrocortisone 6 mg TDS. Okay, fludrocortisone. Then hepatorenal syndrome. How it causes pre-renal failure? It's an idiopathic situation. Pre-renal failure with pre-existing liver disease like hepatitis, maybe cirrhosis of liver, maybe cancer of liver, maybe chronic liver disease, maybe acute liver disease, so many. With already existing liver disease, it itself causes pre-renal failure. How to diagnose hepatorenal syndrome? Administer 1.5 liter normal saline and see the renal function is improved. Output increases, urine comes faster, which shows there is the cause behind it known as hepatorenal syndrome. And how to treat this situation, how to improve pre-renal failure here? You have to correct the underlying cause, underlying hepatic disease you need to treat. So my dear friends, it's already I finished with pre-renal failure. I already explained post-renal failure. And in my next video, I am going to explain you only intrinsic renal failure, renal causes. So if you have any queries, any questions, you can ask me. And if you still not subscribe my channel, please subscribe it. And if you want to study any topic, you can ask me. I am ready to answer. Have a good day. Goodbye and good luck.